I've been really looking forward to making this series for a long time now. When we start learning web development, a lot of times we begin with the basics of HTML and CSS, and that gets us a long ways. At some point, though, we reach a limit in what we can accomplish using just HTML and CSS. As we begin to use frameworks or CMSs like Drupal, we become further and further separated from our HTML and CSS. In fact, you can build a Drupal site without touching HTML and CSS at all. In a lot of ways, this lowers the barrier to entry so people can build complicated, rich applications and websites without having to learn any new languages. The problem, though, is that sometimes with frameworks or CMSs, you do need to get into the code and modify HTML and CSS, or at least be fluent enough to be able to read the code and know what's going on. So part of the series is focused on developing those basic HTML, CSS, and also JavaScript skills, even though that alone will afford you a lot of flexibility when it comes to developing your own applications. My ulterior motive is that I want to build up to the point where we can talk about some of the modern tools and techniques that are available to us now for front-end development. Tools like a CSS preprocessor called SASS, responsive design and how to tackle responsive images, automation tools like Grunt and Gulp, dealing with accessibility and looking at the tools we have to optimize front-end performance, a number of JavaScript libraries that enhance our ability to create rich interfaces, and standards around how to organize our CSS like SMACs. These are the things that I'm the most excited to get into, and we will, but first we have to start with basic HTML and CSS skills.